Hello and welcome. In this 14-day beginner challenge, you're going to start your app journey off with a bang. You're going to learn how apps are made and how they end up on the App Store. You're going to get familiar with Xcode and how to start your very own app project. You're going to learn how to build user interfaces with SwiftUI. And you're going to learn Swift programming basics so that you can read and write simple Swift code. Now, in the next 14 lessons, you're going to gain all of these new skills, and you're going to have built your very own app that you can install on your device and show all of your friends and family what you've done. More importantly than that, however, you will be extremely confident and excited to continue growing your app development skills beyond what we've covered here. This really could be the start of something new for you. Now, just in case you're new around here, my name is Chris, and welcome to Code with Chris, the place to be if you want to learn how to make an app. We've taught thousands of people with no coding experience how to code and how to make apps, and I'm sure that we can do the same thing for you. On that note, why are you here learning app development? Let me know by leaving a quick comment below. And on your way down there, if you wouldn't mind, please give this video a quick thumbs up. It really helps the video out, and I appreciate that so much. Okay, so if you're ready, let's roll up our sleeves and get started. I'm going to walk through this diagram, and then after, I'll tell you where to get all of the pieces. It all starts with the Xcode IDE. Now, IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment, which is a term for the application and all of the tools a developer uses to build something. For the rest of this course, we'll simply call it Xcode. This is where we build our app by writing Swift code, building the user interface, or UI for short, and connecting it with all of our data. Swift is the programming language we use to express our logic and to tell the system what we want to do. We can even build the UI through Swift code, as you'll soon see. Now, SwiftUI is a UI framework that makes it easy for us to rapidly build apps for all of Apple's platforms. A nice benefit of learning Xcode, Swift, and SwiftUI is that they're the same skills and tools used to build all apps for all of Apple's platforms, including iOS, iPadOS, tvOS, watchOS, and macOS. And in some cases, your app will be able to work on multiple platforms without much changes at all. Now, once your app is built, you could distribute it with Apple's App Store. This is done by joining the Apple Developer Program, which requires an annual enrollment fee. Once you're enrolled, you get access to multiple benefits, including the App Store Connect portal, Testflight, and the Provisioning portal. There are some more benefits, including access to beta software and support from Apple engineers, and I'll provide a link to the full list below. The Provisioning portal gives you access to tools for identifying and code signing your app. It's like putting your signature on the app so that Apple can identify who built it. And this is important for the safety of the end users downloading your app, and it's also important for you because it stops malicious coders from pretending to be you. Once your app is in a testable state, Testflight allows you to invite people to download and beta test your app. They'll be able to send feedback and bug reports directly to you through the Testflight program. Use Testflight to ensure that your app is as polished as it can be before launch. And finally, App Store Connect is where you'll create the app listing for your app, including all of the metadata and screenshots. If your app has in-app purchases, this is also where you would configure them. Once your app is tested and the listing is ready, you can upload the app from Xcode to App Store Connect. From there, the certification team at Apple will review your app to ensure that it meets the App Store quality guidelines. This takes a couple of days, and don't worry if you fail because you can fix whatever they point out and resubmit it for review. If everything looks good, they'll approve the app and your app will be live. Congratulations! Alright, so where can you get these different pieces of the Apple developer ecosystem? You can download Xcode for free from the Mac App Store. I'll provide a link below. You don't need to get Swift or SwiftUI. Those just come with Xcode. As for the Apple Developer Program, I'll provide a link to the enrollment page below. I want to mention that joining the Apple Developer Program is completely optional. If your goal isn't to distribute apps into the App Store, don't join it. You'll still be able to learn how to build apps for yourself.
So that's the Apple Developer Ecosystem. It's the process that I'll be taking you through if you continue on with this app journey. Now, by the end of this learning path, you'll be building your own apps using all of these tools that we've covered, even if you don't have any coding experience right now. I promise you, you'll be surprised at what you can do by the end of this challenge. Now, I highly recommend that you go over to codewithchris.com and create an account. You can take this same course and get all of the supplemental material and get access to all of the quizzes and exercises to make your learning truly effective. In fact, if you go and do that right now, there is a quiz that you can take to reinforce what you've learned here today. Now, the last thing I want to say is thank you, and I appreciate it so much that you're learning with me. In the next lesson, we're going to dive right into Xcode, and if you don't want to miss it, make sure you're subscribed to the channel by hitting that subscribe button below and turn on bell notifications so that you get notified. All right, I'll see you in the next lesson.